शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरु परम्पराम् श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मीति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहना भवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं ये वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तदुम्हदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रति। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेश नमो मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धे बुद्धिं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वनिर्गुणं पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहन्नमत्वनित्य मे निश्चिता मतिः। So we are looking at the Atvadrishti's Prashna, and the answer to the Adhamadhikari is given the way it is given to an Uttamadhikari also, where the question ceases to be. But for an Adhamadhikari, the questions do not come to an end easily. There are many questions and all of them have to be addressed. What Sadhu does here is that he takes the Uttamadhikari Prakriya, and within that Prakriya he fits in all the answers to the questions of the Adhamadhikari also. So Tarkadrishti is going to get all answers in the Swapna Prakriya. Swapnavat Mithya is being shown, and through the example of the Swapna Sadhaka, Swapna Guru, Swapna Vedanta, Swapna Prashnaha, Swapna Uttaraha, based on those, the Uttamadhikari Swapnavat Mithyatvam of Prapancha, the Drishti Srishti Vada is also established. So that is what is being done here. We were just a moment. So that is what is being done here in the 346 Avarta. मिथ्याचारेण मिथ्या शिष्याय मिथ्या संस्कृत ग्रंथेन उपदेशः। दी टीचिंग टू दी शिष्य हु इज मिथ्या बाय दी आचार्य हु इज मिथ्या इज डन यूजिंग व्हाट मेथडोलॉजी? द मेथडोलॉजी रिवील्ड इन दी मिथ्या ग्रंथ विच हैपेंस टू बी इन संस्कृत, basically Veda Vedanta. So the teaching is itself mithya because your bandha is mithya, jivatva bhava is mithya, therefore moksha is also going to be mithya. There is only one satpadartha, and eka sattavada is this drishti srishti vada even to the adama adhikari. So that is the beauty of the grantha, does not let you slip from the final vision. All the questions are answered within that prakriya itself, and those questions can be anything. So starting with granthārambhe mangalācaraṇam. Mangalācarana, if everything is mithya, why should one do mangalācarana? It should be done. Why? As long as the sharīra prārabdha is there, which itself is mithya, why not do Mithya Mangalacharana also? So people say Ishwara is Mithya. Yes, Ishwara is Mithya. Ishwara is Mithya for a person who knows that his Jiva Bhava is Mithya. Holding on to your Jiva Bhava, you cannot say Ishwara is Mithya. Prapancha won't be Mithya then. Prapancha remains real. Jivatva Bhava remains real. Ishwara, if you say is Mithya at that stage, then it will lead to adhugati, because a person will think that I am Ishwara, which is Asuri Sampada as per Gita Acharya. So Grantharambhe Mangalacharana, all these questions are answered as to if there is a set of obstacles which does not help the person see that I can get moksha. I can get moksha the way I can get it in swapna. Here also mithya. And that will lead to real freedom, which is my own swarupa. Leading is also figurative. So granthaarambhya mangalacharanam kartavyaha. Kartavyam, mangalacharanam kartavyam. Mangalacharanasya prayojanam. What is the purpose of that? Mangalacharana prakara bhedascha. What are the different types of mangalacharanas? Granthaarambhya avashyam mangalacharam. Mangalam acharitavyam. Mangalam is mangalacharanam. So mangalasya acharanam kartavyam. That is this mangalam acharitavyam. Acharanam kartavyam means acharitavyam. Mangalacharana grantha samapti pratibandhi bhuta vigna vinashyanti. Mangalacharanas are not only done in the beginning, they are also done in the end. They are also done in the middle, in bigger granthas. I think Bhagavan Karikakara does that, does a mangalacharana in between also. Or you will see it in bigger Upanishads where Tikakara will do it in Taittiriya or such larger Upanishads. So mangalacharana has to be done at least in the beginning. Mangalacharana grantha samapti pratibandhi bhuta vignaha vinashyanti. Why? Because the very purpose of beginning a particular text, Arambha, is to see the end. And it should reach the masses. It should have usefulness. If the author is unable to complete it, then it will not serve the purpose and completion will not take place unless the obstacles are removed. These obstacles are pratibandhas, called pratibandha bhuta vignaha. Vinashyanti mangalacharanya. Vigno nama papameva. And what is vigna? Vigna is papa. Now this papa can be not only of the author. The author will also have papa even if he is a jnani. Prarabdha vashat, there will be papa fructifying, which may be presenting obstacles to the grantha samapti also. And there is samashti prarabdha also which is acting. Those towards whom the grantha caters, their prarabdha, their papa does not allow the author to complete the grantha. Papena pratibaddhani bhutva shubhakaryani na siddhyanti. So shubhakaryas will not see siddhi. Tani cha papani mangalacharana nashyanti. Therefore mangalacharana should be done to counter those obstacles. Papa rahitena api granthado mangalam acharaniyam eva. So why would guru have papa? Okay, let's say that guru does not have papa, but still he has to do it because lokasangrahartam, others will follow them. Tadakarane granthakartari purushanam nastikattva bhrantya tadiya granthe pravruttir nasyat. What is the other problem? If a person who is very well respected, he does not do mangalacharana in the grantha, then what happens? Those who are astikas, who would otherwise follow the grantha, they will look at the author as nastika because he has not done mangalacharana. Some kind of mangalacharana should be there. It may be implicit, but it should be there. In Vyakrana also, in Vyakrana Sutra starts with no mangalacharana. This is the Purva Paksha. But what did Panini Maharshi do? He started with the word Vriddhi. Vriddhi Radhaich. Adeng Gunaha. So Guna word, which is a definition of Attaneng, went second in the second sutra. That is also there is noise in the background. So you'll have such words which are explained by the Tikas as Mangalacharana. So Tachya Mangalam Trividam. वस्तु निर्देश रूपम आशीर्वाद रूपम नमस्कार रूपम चेति. सो थ्री टाइप्स आर देर. वस्तु निर्देश वस्तु इज वसती वस्तु ब्रह्म. दैट मंगलाचरण विच रिवील्स ब्रह्म तत्व रिकॉल्स ब्रह्म तत्व एंड रिवील्स टू दी शिष्यास दैट इज वस्तु निर्देश रूप मंगलाचरण. देन आशीर्वाद रूप मंगलाचरण. Somebody who is a sadhaka or has a bhava to present that I am, you know, even Bhagavad Padacharya, when he is creating stotras, there the stotras are not from the perspective of a siddha. Stotras are from the perspective of a sadhaka. So he wears the garb of a sadhaka and then creates the stotras. So the granthakara also plays the role of the sadhaka, says that, you know, bless me. And asking for those blessings from Ishvara, Guru, Ityadi, that is Ashirvada Rupa Mangalacharana. Namaskara Rupa is just submitting yourself to whichever deity or whichever is Ishta Devata you see, or Kula Devata or Guru. So that is Namaskara. Sagunaha Athva Nirguno Yah Paramatma Sa Vastu Iti Abhidiyate. So this Vastu can be Saguna as well as Nirguna. Sometimes it is Saguna and Nirguna. Many places you will see Saguna and Nirguna. Both will be there in the same Mangalacharan. And it need not be a single word, it can be many. Now, after so many chapters, why Mangalacharana is being discussed? Mangalacharana has been discussed initially also, at the beginning, in the first chapter. But here, in the sixth chapter, the Adama Adhikari is facing difficulties to understand. So many things have been told to the two elder brothers. This does not gel well with the Tarkadrishti Sadhaka. Sadhaka who has Tarka Pradhanya. And Tarka cannot be Shushka Tarka. It is not working. So, the entire Prakriya has to be brought in again, starting with Mangalacharana. Do whichever Mangalacharana which fits you, but do Mangalacharana. Meaning, it is shown that Tattva Drishti is lacking that. And here it is for Agrudha Deva, of course. Agrudha Deva is the Sapna Drashta here. Who is himself Atma really, Chaitanya, but does not know. Same as Tarka Drishti who does not know. So for him, the Guru is Mithya, who is helping him understand the Tattva through Mithya Upadesha with Mangalacharana Ityadi. So everything has to be taught. Which are all Mithya now, because they are all in Agrudha Deva's Swapna. All this is taking place in Agrudha Deva's Swapna. So Tachya Mangalam Trividham. And then, what is this Vastu Nirdesha? It can be Saguna or Nirguna Vastu. Tasya Kirtanam Eva Vastu Nirdesha. And revealing is Kirtana itself. Kirtana is narration of that Vastu. Atmanaha Atva Shishyasya Vanchitam Tasya Prarthanam Eva Ashirvada Rupa Mangalam. So whatever is the desire of the sadhaka, what is it? For Mumukshu it is Moksha. So that which is desirable to a person, so Atmana this reflects you. Atmanaha Shishyasya Va. For a Shishya or for oneself who does not consider himself as Shishya also maybe, who may himself be Guru, who may be an Acharya, but he has written the Grantha so that it reaches Shishya. So that may be the desire, that let it reach and be useful. So that is Vanchita. Vanchita phala tasya prarthanam eva ashirvada rupa mangalam. Swapakarsha bodhananukula namashabdocharanadi rupo vyaparaha namaskara rupa mangalam. Using the namashabda, putting all the recipient, basically, Sampradana Chaturthi, and Namashabda will also govern that. So they are using all that. Namashabda or something similar also may be there. That is Namaskar Rupa Mangala. Grantharambe Ganesha Devyad Janusandhanam Api Mangalacharanam Eva. Now you say that Ishara should be offered Namaskaras to, not no, these Devatas who are Jivas. Jivas who have attained Devata Rupa because of their Punya Karma in the earlier Janmas. But whenever a person looks at an Ishta Devata, it is the manifestation of the same Ishara. Now Ganesha, in the beginning, here also, you know, Chidghana Ganeshaya Namo Mayyam. So what kind of Mangalacharana is this? It is Nirguna also. Vastu Nirdesha is also there. Saguna is also there. Namaskara Rupa Mangala is also there in a very short, a single sentence. Few words. Shri Chidghana Ganeshaya Namo Mayyam. Mayyam is there for Samanadi Karanyam. You've seen this. Now this Ganesha Devata is son of Shiva, son of Parvati. What kind of Mangala Charana is this? Ganeshasya Devyahacha Isharatvam Puraneshu Prasiddham. Purana says that Ganesha is not a general Devata. Who is not a Jiva? Who has got Ganesha Rupa? It is Ishvara. Devyascha Isharatvam. So whether it is Ganesha or Devi, they are all Ishvara. Tasmad Ganeshadinam Chinta Na Anishvara Chinta. There are people who say, no, we will only think about Vishnu. Vaishnavas will say, no other God is acceptable to us. Nobody else is God. So they are given to the name and form. Attached to a particular name and form, which is okay, but not the Ninda of the other Devatas, who are also manifestation of the same Ishvara. Purane Ganeshasya yad janmoktam tad jivana jivanam iva na karma phalabhuta janma. So Purana mentions the janma which is not, you know, regular janma. Ganesha janma, we know that it is not regular janma. Ramakrishna adir iva Ganesha api bhuktanugra prayojana kaha paramatmana avirbhava vishesha evaiti bhagavato vyasasya paramabhiprayaha. So Bhagavan Vyasacharya says that in Purana, just like Ramakrishnas are avatars, and being avatars, they look like manushyas, but they are Ishwaras. Similarly, Ganesha also is a devata, has a particular role to play, but then still he is Ishwara. Atrai idam rahasyam. Now this is a secret which Sadhu says that it should be kept in mind. Whenever you look at Mangalacharana of a particular devata, paramartha drishtya jivopi paramatmana navinnaha. So one who is doing Mangalacharana, that jiva is also paramatma. Jiva brahmaiva naparaha paramartha drishtya. There is only one drishti really, where there is no drishti at all. In paramartha there is no drishti. So paramartha drishti is a drishti of a person from vyavaharika. Vyavaharika drishti. Vyavaharika drishtya. Paramartha drishti iti vadati ityeva. It's not really true. Kintu janana maranadi rupa bandasya atmani yodhyasaha sa eva jivasya jivatvam. Because jivatva bhava, that limitedness that one has, giving up one's own purnatva, is because of adhyasa, avidya krita. Sacha janmadi rupa bandha ganeshadinam atmanina pratiyate. This jiva has jivatva bhava, but Ganesha, Devi, they don't have this jivatva bhava. They know they are purna, they know they are brahma swarupa. This they is also pluralistic thinking from the perspective of the jiva. That name and form is also adhyastha really. If you look at the Purana context also, thereby you may talk about multiple devatas. But still, if you look at those devatas as an individual also, Then from their antakkarana, what is a vritti? If you look into that, they don't have this jiva bhava at all. They are playing a role, not considering the role as real. Just like a parent may play with a child. So child is cooking something, she brings some, the daughter brings some utensils and says that I'm cooking something. Dad, have tea. Have this and tell me how it is. I made this, eat your lunch and tell me how it is. Dad knows that there is nothing there, but he plays the role. The kid does not know that. The kid thinks that it is real. At that age, he thinks that it is real. So, loka sangraha. So, sacha janmadi rupa vandha ganeshadi nam atmanina pratiyate. They don't have this pratiti also. Brahma isn't there at all. Tasmat tena jivaha. Therefore, ganeshadi devatas are not jiva. Anena prakarna ganeshadi nam ishvaratvam siddham. So, ganesha, etc., all these where mangalacharana is done, these. The Mangalacharana Karta also knows that. But he invokes that role in Ishvara, invokes that name and form of Ishvara and expects Vanchita Phala. Therefore, Mangalacharana. Yushtam yada pasyat kenyam ishamasya mahimanam iti vita shokaha, says Mundaka Upanishad. So there are two birds sitting on the tree. One bird is sadhu atte. So it's the phala of the karma. Because he is a karta, forced to be a bhokta. The other bird is watching. As long as the other bird, there is dvaita bhava then. Dvaita bhava is Ishvara is different. I am different. Ishvara is karma phala data. I am karma phala bhokta. I am a karma karta and karma phala bhokta. Ishvara is karma phala data. Who is watching over? Sarvadhi sakshi rupa Ishvara. Now that Ishvara is different. He is watching over. I am the karmi. So that is the bheda between the two words. But the Upanishad says further what? Yushtam yada pasyat kanyam isham asya mahimanam miti. Then when he looks at the other as not being other, sarupena, when he knows aikya between that second bird, which is not second at all, the bird knows the other bird as oneself, then what is that other there? There is a karma phala bhokta jiva, thereby jiva. So atma, which is karma phala bhokta, becomes this first bird, and atma, which is not karma phala bhokta, sakshi, becomes the second bird. So based on where you have your vritti, you will have jivatva bhava or you will be free from it. So when you look at the other as your own Swarupa. Why is it other? Because the Swarupa, your Swarupa is veiled and looks like other. Once the Avarna goes away, this Vikshepa is not confusing anymore. So then, Mahimanam, you know that the greatness of that Atma is that it was never bound. Thereby Vita Shokaha. So, vitam, shokam yasmat sa vita shoka, the person becomes, vigata shoka, becomes free from dukkha. So, Shvetashvatara Upanishad also has it. Asya mantra se ayamata, what is the meaning? Anyam, devopadika, jivad vilakshanam, isham, asamsarinam, mahimanam, sarvasya jagataha, ayam, ahamasmi, Atma, sarvabhutastha, na itaraha, avidya, janitopadi, parichinno, mayatmeti, jagadrupam, vibhutim, pashyati. So one who sees, what does he see? Anya is devopadika jivad vilakshanam. One who is other than this jiva, who is bhranta, really. that Isha is asamsari, Ishvara. One who sees asamsari jiva, asamsari Ishvara, who is separate from this jiva, and what does he see really? That mahima, sarvasya jagata ayam ahamasmi, that mahima is that anantya of Ishvara cannot leave me aside. Anya from whom? Jivad vilakshana, that jiva is me, aham. So mattaha vilakshanaha yaha Ishvara tasya mahimanam kim. So when you look at that mahima of that Ishvara, what is that mahima of Ishvara? He is ananta. That anantya of Ishvara is not possible if I am separate from him. So jivad vilakshana is what I've been thinking so far. But if jivad vilakshana Ishvara, then Ishvara cannot be ananta. Because at least I will be separate from him. At least I will be separate. Maybe all other jivas are included, but I am separate. If I am separate, then I will limit that Ishvara. He will not be ananta. But the Shastra says Ishvara is ananta. Brahma is ananta tattva. Thereby, he is not different from me. Now, whether I am an Ausha or not is open to discussion there. Shruti says that Tattvamasi, Aham Brahmasmi. So, therefore, Aunshi Bhava, Aunsha Aunshi Bhava will also not be established. It will be shown as erroneous confusion. So, that is the Mahima. When one sees that Mahima, Mahimanam Pashyati, which is Sarvasya Jagata Ayam, Yaha Ishvara, Saha Aham Asmi, Atma. Who is that Ishvara? Sarva Bhutastha. So, I am also Sarva Bhutastha Atma. Na Itaraha. So, that Anya, na itaraha. Start from anya, but land on na itaraha. Then what is that anyatvam? Avidya janitopadi parichinna. That anyatva is prapta due to parichinnatva being there. I feel limited. Why do I feel limited? Because of the upadi of the sharira, shariratraya. Avidya janita. Mayatmeti jagadrupa vibhutim. So mayatma, not really, mayatma is magical. This magical formation of an individual, which is not real, it is a projection. Adhyasa, vikshepa, jagadrupa vibhutim is the meaning of this mahimanam. Asyeti. Mama Parameshwarasya evaiti yada pashyati. So when he looks at, first he looks at Ishvara's mahima, then he looks at his own mahima, because there is no bheda between the two. So mama Parameshwarasya. Parameshwarasya mama. Both are in samanadikam. Yada pashyati. When one sees, then tada vita shokaha bhavati. Vita shokaha sarvasmat shokasagara vimuchyate kritakatya bhavatyatyatha. So becomes kritakritya. So all that has to be done. Kritani, krityani, yena. Yena sadhakena sa siddha bhavati. Therefore kritakritya is one who has nothing to do. Everything is as good as done. So antargata, all phala is antargata in moksha. Sarvasma shoka sagara vimuchyate. He is freed from samsara sagara, which is dukkha rupa. Iti bhashya varnito artha. This is from bhashya. Under that mundaka mantra. Tasmad granthaarambe ganesha adinam chintanam upapadyate. Therefore, even in the mithya setup, a vyavastha is there. Mangalacharana should be done. Isharasya nana rupa varnanam sarvesham isharatva jyotanaya. Why are these many forms there? Ishvara takes many forms. Sarvesham isharatva jyotanaya. So description is given in many ways. All of them are Ishvara. All these devatas which are discussed. Guru bhakti hi Ishvara bhaktischa vidya praptavanta विद्या प्राप्तो अंतरंग साधनम इति द्योतनाय च. सो गुरु भक्ति, गुरु भक्ति एंड ईश्वर भक्ति, वाई इज देयर भक्ति, वाई शुड भक्ति बी देयर? भक्ति शोज द्वैत भाव इनिशियली, देन इट शुड ग्रेजुएट इनटू अद्वैत भक्ति. सो गुरु भक्ति ईश्वर भक्ति इज ऑल वैलिड, इवन इफ इट इज मिथ्या इट इज वैलिड. वाई? बिकॉज इट इज अंतरंग साधना टू विद्या प्राप्ति, एंड विद्या अविद्यानाश, अविद्यानाशे सति मोक्षः. सो विद्या प्राप्तो अंतरंग साधनम इति द्योतनाय च. टू रिवील दैट एज वेल, गुरु भक्ति ईश्वर भक्ति शुड बी रिटेन. निर्गुण सगुण वस्तु निर्देश रूप नमस्कार रूप आशीर्वाद रूप मंगल प्रदर्शन. सो सैंपलिंग्स आर गिवन एज टू व्हाट आर ईच टाइप्स ऑफ मंगलाचरण. तत्र निर्गुण वस्तु रूप, निर्गुण वस्तु निर्देश रूप मंगल यथा. सर एग्जाम्पल फॉर निर्गुण वस्तु निर्देश रूप मंगलाचरण, इन दी अर्लियर वस्तु निर्देश रूप मंगलाचरण देयर निर्गुण एंड सगुण भेद. निर्गुण इज परिपूर्णं चिदानंदं बुद्धि साक्ष्यद्वयं सूर्यादिभासकं नित्यं तेजःशुद्धं तदस्म्यहम्. परिपूर्णं चिदानंद्यं, चित वी नो, आनंद ऑल्सो वी नो, बुद्धि साक्षी, बुद्धेः साक्षी, साक्षी हियर इज न्यूटर देयरफॉर ह्रस्व. यद् अद्वयं, दैट विच इज नॉन ड्यूअल, अद्वितीयं, विच इज बुद्धि साक्षी. बुद्धि हैज द मीनिंग ऑफ अंतकरण और विद द फर्स्ट अटैचमेंट विच इज मैनिफेस्ट. आनंदमय कोश इज देयर बट इट यू कैनॉट एनालाइज द आनंदमय कोश एज कोश अनलेस देयर इज बुद्धि. बुद्धि संबंध मेक्स विज्ञानमय कोश संबंध. यू आर अ साक्षी टू दैट विज्ञानमय कोश ऑल्सो. अंतकरण बुद्धि जनरली इज यूज अंतकरण ऑल्सो हियर. सूर्यादि भासकम, सो द बृहत मंत्र देयर इज अ क्वेश्चन एज टू हु रिवील्स द सूर्य ऑल्सो. सूर्य रिवील्स द एंटायर वर्ल्ड. हु रिवील्स सूर्य? बिकॉज द सीरीज ऑफ क्वेश्चन, इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ सूर्य हु रिवील्स द वर्ल्ड? चंद्र. इन द एब्सेंस ऑफ चंद्र सम लैंप अग्नि. इफ दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉट देयर शब्द. Somebody calls you out and then you know which direction to take in dark night. Okay, shabda is also missing. What about in sapna? Jagrata avastha, sapna, how do you see all of this? In sapna also surya ityadi, surya, chandra, agni, shabda ityadi, all the shabda, who someone narrates, someone yells out to you, calls out to you. Even that person is created by you. So just like in sapna, Surya ityadi, all of these bhasakas are brought about by you. Similarly, in Jagrata avastha also, Surya cannot reveal the vastu unless Surya is revealed by you. Satta is also given by Brahmatma. Therefore, Suryadi bhasakam nityam. Trikala badita sat, that nitya shows sat. Tejaha. तेजस, न्यूटर अगेन, तेज शुद्धम तद अस्मि अहम. आई एम दैट, फाइनली दैट ब्रह्म तत्व विच इज निर्गुण. ऑल दीज आर स्वरूप, दीज आर नॉट विशेषण विच आर कैटेगराइजिंग ब्रह्म एंड सेपरेटिंग ब्रह्म फ्रॉम अनदर ब्रह्म, अनदर नॉन ब्रह्म, और डिफाइनिंग ब्रह्म विथ सम काइंड ऑफ पार्ट्स एंड डिफरेंशिएटिंग. दैट इज नॉट दिस word paripurnam chidanandam chit anandam buddhi sakshi. All these mean, they mean the swarupa, they are lakshana. You cannot have anything other than brahma, so they are not visheshanas which separate out. They are meant to separate out brahma from non brahma, and they are also not differentiating brahma from another brahma because there is no other brahma. So sajatiya vijatiya swagata veda rahita brahma is being mentioned here, and what is the lakshana, all these words, and then finally aham asmi. I am that. This is nirguna vastu nirdesha rupa mangala. Saguna vastu nirdesha rupa mangala yatha mangala yatha. That is vighna samulan nashyanti yanna mocharana sakrat tripuragnopi yansvartva jaghana tripurasuran vinatu yena devascha svepsitannanu napnuvantihi sarva vighna vinashaya chidganeshan namamitam. So there is a tippana here. Tripura Gnaha. First point, I think. So Mahadeva, the meaning is Mahadeva. Because we see him as a destroyer. In Purana, destroyer is basically unmanifest all this. So vignaha samulam, all these vignas samulam nashyanti. Just the vignas going away for the moment is useless. We want them to go in such a manner that they are uprooted. How do they go away? Yan namo charana na sakrat. Completely they go away by a single mention of that name. Single remembrance or utterance of that name. Whose name? Yasya namocharanat. So yasya namocharanat sakrat, sakrat namocharanat. By even uttering once, all the vignas are destroyed, uprooted completely. Who is that? Tripuragnaha. Apiyam svrutva. That is someone whom even the Mahadeva recalls. Yam smritva tripuragna api jaghana tripurasuran. So there in Purana there is a katha that when Mahadeva Shiva went for a battle to destroy these asuras, that time he did namaskara to Ganesha. So I think that is the story here. Mahadeva yada vijayam nalabhata tadasa sarvaihi devaihi sahita vignarajam ganesham aradhya vijayam avapa. Mahadevasya vijayena deva nirvaya abhavanniti katha puraneshu prasiddha. So there is a story in the Purana where Mahadeva Shiva was not able to win over the asuras, but he did na aradhana of Ganesha, who is Vignaraja. Although he is his own son, but still playing that role of Vignanasha. Vinatu yena devascha svepsitam napnuvantihi sarva vigna vinashaya chitganesha namamitam. Who is that Ganesha really? So Ganesha has a rupa, so saguna. Without whom all these devas do not get whatever they want. All the other devas also have to worship for, they have worshipped Ganesha for their vanchita phala. In the case of Mahadeva in the story here, his own father, who is Mahadeva, also had to worship Ganesha. Who is that Ganesha really? Ishvara, who is Chid Ganesha, Chaitanya Rupa really. Sarva Vigna Vinashaya, why do you do it? So, Tadarthya Chaturthi, Sarva Vighana Vinashaya. Namaskara Rupa Mangala Yatha. Then sampling of Namaskara Rupa Mangala. Asuranam, Nihantaram, Trataram, Surachetasam, Ramakantam, Umakantam, Namam, Anisham, Advayam. So, Asuranam, Nihantaram, Trataram, Surachetasam. For Asuras, destructive force and protector for those who are good cheta, good antakarana, sushtu mana. Ramakantam, Umakantam, Namami, Anisham, Advayam. So that Advaya Tattva, who is Ramakanta? Umakanta also. If you look at Rama, Ramakanta We look at it as Rama or Vishnu. Umakanta is Shiva. So Namami, who is Advaya, there cannot be two. There is no Vishnu and Shiva Bheda also. Guroho Svavanchita Prarthana Rupa Rupam Ashirvada Mangalam. So Prarthana Rupa. There should be Dirga here, I think. So Guru Svavanchita Prarthana Rupa Ashirvada Mangalam. Sorry. So I still have a sore throat. So what does the Guru want really? Who is creating a grantha there? There is some vanchita phala there also. So Ashirvada is expected there. Yaya shaktya deva devo jagat srishtya adhikaramakrut sametishtatu vakpithe granthasyasya samaptaye. So what is the vanchita phala? Samapti of the grantha. So for this samapti of the grantha, that Devi, who is Saraswati, Sakshat Vidya Rupini, let her be on my Vaktirtha. So whatever I am narrating, let it see its end and reach the masses and be useful, not for my sake and not through my Shakti. By that Shakti which can get anything done. Yaya Shaktya, through whose Shakti? So generally we look at Devi in this Vakpitha. So Vaktre Saraswati Tishtatu. So Deva Deva, all the Deva, Devanavapi Deva, Yaya Shaktya, Jagat Srishtyadi Karmakrut. So you see this in Devi Purana Ityadi. Navratri, in Navratri you will see all this coming to forefront, that all these devas, Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha also, did Jagat Srishti Ityadi just by the Shakti of Devi. Let that Devi be on my Vakpitha, so that Granthasya Samapti Bhavati. Shishyasya Svanchita Prarthana Rupa Mangalam. When Shishya is doing Mangalacharana, how would it be? Which is Prarthana Rupa Mangala, Samsara Bandha Samshantya Nijananda Prakashanat Nivartayatu Janmadi Dukkham Shishyasya Me Guruhu. Samsara Bandha Samshantya Nijananda Prakashanat. All these are Hetu. Nivartayatu. Let there be Nivartti. Of what? Janmadi Dukkha. Starting from Janma itself is Dukkha Rupa. People think that Marana is Dukkha Rupa. No, Janma is Dukkha Rupa. While being born, the birth is painful for the mother as well as the child. So Janma is Dukkha Rupa for both. After the Janma, there is Sukha, all right, for the parents, but the child is still crying. Why? Because Janma is Dukkha Rupa. The gestation period is also Dukkha Rupa. Marana is Dukkha Rupa. Through and through between Janma and Marana also Dukkha Rupa. Something or the other will be there. That is why Mukti is necessary. That is why everyone is looking for Ananda Rupa in every endeavor. Nivartayetu Shishyasya. So Guru Nivartayetu. Let Guru take away Janmadi Dukkha of the Shishya. Who is the Shishya? Aham Eva Shishya. So he is writing this saying that Me Shishyasya. So Me Guru Hu. So both ways you can do. Me Shishyasya Janmadi Dukkha. And Me Guru Hu. Me is Mama there. Mama Guru Hu. Janmadi Dukkha. Shishyasya Me. Me can go both ways. Deli Deepanyayana. So, me guru hu, me shishyasya. So, mama janmadi dukkham, kasam shishyaha. So, let him take away my dukkha. So that is the type of Mangalacharana. Vedanta Shastra Pranetuhu Acharyasya Shri Veda Vyasasya Namaskaraha. Vedanta Nama Upanishadha. Vedanta is Upanishad, we know that. Tasam Tatparyasya Niranaya Katvat. Tad Anusari Brahma Sutra Rupottaram Uttaram Imamsa. So, Vedanta, which is basically Upanishads, which are Uttaram Imamsa, Darshana, established in Brahma Sutras, created by Vyasacharya. So, Tasam Upanishadam Tatparyasya Niranayakatva Tadanusari Brahma Sutra Rupa Uttaramimamsa Akhya Shariraka Shastramapi Vedanta Shastram Ityuchyate. Brahma Sutra is called as Vedanta by extension. Gita is also called as Upanishad by Vedanta by extension. Primarily, Shruti is the Prasthana. Traya, in that Shruti Prasthana is Vedanta Prasthana. All three are included in Prasthana, but Shruti Prasthana, Smriti Prasthana and Nyaya Prasthana. Smriti Prasthana is a derivative of Shruti. Nyaya Prasthana, Brahma Sutra, establishes the Tatparya of the Shruti, which is Vedanta really. So Upanishad Tatparya Niranaya has been done in Brahma Sutra. Therefore, Brahma Sutra, which is Uttara Mimamsa, called as Vedanta Uttara Mimamsa, Purva Mimamsa being Karma Kanda, that Shariraka Shastramapi is called as Vedanta Shastram. Tatkarta Shri Veda Vyasa, that Veda Vyasa, what is his Namaskara? Tasya Namaskara. So, Drishtanta Vane Vayikurta Anartha. There is one example used to explain this Namaskara to Vyasa. Actually, it is Namaskara to Vyasa. Vyasacharya, Tasya Namaskara. Maybe a little confusing here, but here it looks like, if you look at the revelation in the next avarta, you see that Vedanta Shastra Pranetu Acharyasya Namaskara. In Brahma Sutra, he used Atha. So that is the Tatparya there. But then, initially, who is this Vyasacharya that is revealed here? He used Atha Shabda, hidden to Mangalacharana. Differently, it was implicit in the Atha to Brahma Jidnyasa with the Atha Shabda. Because Atha and Om, these Shabdas have come from the, their first utterances from Chaturmukha Brahma, they are auspicious. Drishtanta Vane Vayu Kurta Anartaha. So Vayu has brought out a lot of adversities. That is the example, and it will be connected to the exemplified in the next avarta here. So Darshtantika is in the next avarta. And these points are given so that you can compare 349 and 350 as to what is the Drishtanta and what is Darshtantika. So this simile says, Vayuhu Vane Prasrutaha Kantaki Vrikshan Kampayitva Vrikshanam Kantakan Prasarya Ramyani Kamala Pushpani Swasthanad Apachidya Kantakesitani Pushpanyasajya Brahmayati. So Vayuhu Brahmayati. So there are these points which are a little distracting because they are in between the Pada also. They have been split at times. So Vayuhu, this Vayuhu, the wind is blowing and what is it doing? Brahmayati. Vane prasrutaha kantakai vrukshan. In the forest there are thorny trees as well as other trees. But then these trees are full of thorns. When there is stormy wind, that time these thorns fall off the tree. Because the trees are shaken. Kampaitva. Having shaken those trees, what does Vayu do? Vrukshanam kantakan prasargya. Having thrown the thorns elsewhere, carrying them elsewhere, also affects the Kamala Pushpas. So the lotus also in the lakes around, Ramyani, Kamala Pushpani, Swasthanad Apachidya, they are also thrown away. Now thorns are thrown as well as the flowers, lotuses are thrown. Lotuses are beautiful, you don't want them to be damaged by the thorns. You want them to be in their pristine beauty. Kantakeshu tani pushpani asajya brahmayati. So mixing up is there because these kamala pushpas are thrown into the thorns which are uprooted from the trees. Then these will get damaged. So tanmarga gamina patikasya kantaka lagnani kamala pushpani drishtvayam chintodita. So chinta udita. To whom? This person who is walking on the path where these thorns as well as lotuses are lying around, the lotuses are damaged due to the thorns. So what is it basically? In the exemplified, we look at it now itself. So Vayu are these Dvaitins, or these Dvaita Acharyas who are teaching Dvaita, Dvaita Shastra. Who are those? All those who are there other than the Advaita Darshana Krita, Darshana Kartas, or Sampradayavit. Other than Advaita Darshana, every Darshana is Dvaita Darshana. I mean, I mentioned this earlier. See, we derive Advaita from Dvaita. How? By applying Nanj. Nad Dvaitam Advaitam. So not two. This is how we get Advaita. Not two. So there is no scope of becoming three, because to become three or four or whatever pluralistic number you have in your mind, you cannot have that number unless there is two. So when two itself is negated, Advaita, it shows that others, in a sense, plurality is not possible. Now you apply Nanj to Advaita. Na Advaitam, Dvaitam. Whatever is not Advaita is Dvaita. This is the other way to look at it. And if you look at it, na Advaitam, Dvaitam, then by that definition, whatever is not Advaita Darshana is all Dvaita, including Buddhism. Shunyavadins, who don't have Eka also, all that will fall in Dvaita. All of those who have had their philosophies earlier, Darshanas, Sankhya, Yoga, Nayayikas, Vaisheshikas, Puromimamsakas, all of those can be set aside as Dvaita. You can also set aside Buddhism, Jainism, all flavors of Buddhism, Jainism, and all the other religions which have come up. In Vedanta itself, you have had, you know, Shuddha Advaita, Dvaita Advaita, or Dvaita, Vishishta Advaita, all of those are Dvaita for us. By saying Na Advaita Dvaitam. So that is in the simile Vayu. All those darshanas, those who are following those darshanas, those who have created those darshanas, those who are spreading those darshanas are all indicated by Vayu. What do? They take away everything other than this Kamala Pushpa, which is Advaita Tattva, Tatparya, and mix it up with all these thorny ideas in the Shruti itself, Puranas. They don't know the Tatparya. They heard the Advaita Tattva, which is the Tatparya of the Shruti, by misguiding others. They may not know. So, Swayam Bhramita Anyan Brahmayati. What will the confused person do? Will confuse others. So, that is the Drishtanta here. And in Darshtantika, that's how it is going to be connected. And who is this Margagami? Margagami is Vyasacharya. So, he looked at it. How this Advaita Tattva Tatparya Kamala Pushpa is being heard by the thorns, which are the Dvaita Bhava, which is incidental, Adhyaropasthaniya, how it is hurting the Apavada Sthananantara Kamala Pushpa Rupa Advaita. And then he decided to separate them out. So in the example, how it is separated, Sundarani Etani Kamalani Naitat Sthana Yogyani Kintu Uttama Sthana Yogyani Iti. He wanted to put this Kamala Pushpa, which needs a better place, not among thorns. स पतिकस्तानि कमलानि हस्ते गृहीत्वा पुनरपि विचारयामास पवनोऽयं यथा पुनरपि एतानि पुष्पाणि टाइप हुए एतानि पुष्पाणि कंटकेषु न संजयेत. अगेन दे शुड नॉट हर्ट दीज फ्लावर्स दीज थॉर्न्स. सो व्हाट कैन आई डू. अगेन द वायु पवन शुड नॉट हर्ट दीज फ्लावर्स तथा संविधानम कार्यम इति. सो सम काइंड ऑफ अरेंजमेंट हैज टू बी डन. एवं विचार्य सूत्र निर्मित जालकेन कंटकी वृक्षान पृथक चकार तेन जालकेन पुष्पाणि कंटक प्रवेशा परिरक्षितानि. सो व्हाट ही डिड इज ही मेड अ नेट आउट ऑफ अ थ्रेड एंड देन ही सेपरेटेड आउट दीज ट्रीज विच आर थॉर्नी एंड दे वोंट affect these pushpas. So what did he do? He created Puranas. And then Brahma Sutra also, which is Sutra, he threaded the Advaita Tatparya together, separating out the Dvaita, so that the Advaita pushpas are not hurt by the Dvaita thorns. Darshtantikam Shishya Vishaye Bhedavadi Krito Narthaha. So we'll just quickly look through this. In the exemplified, what is Shishya Vishaye Bhedavadi Krutaha Anartaha. So why Krutaha? But here Bhedavadi Krutaha. For whom? For Shishya Vishaya. What is going, finally what will be hurt is the Advaita Tattva really cannot be hurt. Tattva cannot be hurt at all. So Shishya will be hurt because he will not get his goal. He will not reach his goal. Yatha Ayam Drishtanta Tatha Prakrute. In the context, how does this drishtanta apply? Bhedavadi Acharya Rupa Vayuhu. So Bhedavadis, who are called as Acharyas in the Tippana, even that Acharya usage will be shown to be mithya usage. It will not fit the Bhedavadi. Why? Because Atra Bhedavadina Acharya Tukti Devadatti Simhatukti Iva Aupachariki. He says figurative calling Devadatta as Simha. Devadatta is not Simha. Similarly, these Bhedavadis are not really Acharyas. So we look at the Darshtantika. There are a lot of Tippanas there. We look at the Tippana later. So Bhedavadi Acharya Rupa Vayuhu Veda Rupe Vane. Vana is Veda Rupa. Arthavada Rupa Kantaki Vrikshesu Kamakarma Rupan Kantakan Pravartya. What are these thorns? These are Arthavada Rupa. All these kama karma, you'll get this, you do this. You know, all of these are arthavadas really. Karma kandi see Vedanta as arthavada. But towards moksha, which is nitya, all these karma kanda, upasanas, karma, their phala, all these are arthavada because they are not nitya. They are shown as though nitya. So nityatva is arthavada. Mithya karma will lead to mithya phala. One who sees it as real will get real phala, will see the phala as real. That much is okay, but they will not be nitya. So nityatva is arthavada. So arthavada also you look at it. Vidyarthasya stavakatvena nindakatvena cha vividha arthavada. Arthavada is of two types. So nahi ninda naya says that nahi ninda Ninditum pravartate. Hintu videyam stotum. So, even ninda is done in the Shastra not to do ninda. It is not criticism of a particular thing. Dvaita ninda is done. Not to show that Dvaita is completely useless, but to praise Advaita. Or praise of Advaita itself is done directly. So, both types are arthavada. In karma also it is there. Two types of arthavada. Virode gunavadasyal, anuvade avadharite, bhutarthavadas, tadhanad, arthavadas, tridavataha iti. So there are three types. Arthavada, dvivida, and then in that also there is categorization. Mula will also deal with it. Kincha, gudajivhika nyayena, karma phalastuti dvara, nishkama karma pravartaka, parakriti, purakalpa rupascha. So there is a gudajivhika nyaya which is used. Where a bitter medicine cannot be taken. So, while feeding the child a bitter medication, which is good for the child, but the child won't take it. So, what does the mother do? She'll have coated the pill with jaggery, or she'll have jaggery in her hand, and then she'll show the jaggery. The kid pulls out the tongue, she'll put the jaggery on and push the medication also. The kid won't know. So that is Arthavadam. Jaggery, something sweet is shown. In Hindi se gadhe ke saamne gajar. So it is shown, but that is not the truth. Finally, after Apavada, the truth will be revealed. At least, you know, you attract the people by showing Swarga, Sukarupa, so much of Sukha is there. So you do karma ityadi. Chitta Shuddhi is the tatparya there. And then the person will get Advaita Jnana Kramena. Thereby moksha. One who gets stuck there, who spits out the bitter medication thinking that I don't want this, I want jaggery, that won't work. Because the disease won't go. So using guna, there is some guna comparison is there, and then there is arthavada. Then there is anuvada rupa arthavada. What you already know is revealed to you, but it is not a revelation. You think that Veda should reveal something. It is not revealing anything new there. It is telling something that you already know. So it is arthavada by anuvada. So guna comparison or restatement. Then bhutarthavada. Bhutarthavada is something that you don't know. You can't negate also. You didn't know. Shruti does not reveal which can be verified. So something which is said. So Indra Loka is there. Indra is the Adhipati there. Or, you know, Narayana talks about Narayana, there's some sagara talked about. He is at the bottom of that sagara. We don't know all this. We cannot verify also. So, but we don't have enough data to contradict also. So that is Bhutartha Vada. It may be there. So that kind of Artha Vada. So Artha Vada Rupa Kantaki Vrikshesu Kama Karma Rupan Kantakan Pravartya Kapatya Raga Dveshadi Dosha Rahita Sushuddha Shishya Rupa Kamalani Shamadamadi Rupa Swasthanat Pratyavya Kama Karma Rupa Kantakeshu Asajya Brahmayati. So these Vedavadi Acharyas, they confuse the Sushuddha Shishya Rupa Kamalas. So Kamalas are basically Shishyas. Not Advaita Tattva. I said Advaita Tattva there because they get confused as to what is not the Tatparya there. So Shamadamadi Rupa Swasthana Pratyavya. They are led away from Chitta Shuddhi because one will be looking at a different goal. And what are these thorns? Really Kama Karma Rupa. Dvaita will lead to Kama Karma because Avidya. Avidya, Kama Karma. That Avidya gives you Dvaita Bhava, then Kama will be there towards the Dvitiya Padartha and then Karma. This is the confusion whereby somebody is led astray. All these Shishyas are going here and there. Evam Kama Karma Nirata Anuchavacha Samsara Dukha Bhaginaha Drishtva Marga So Margam Gachatiti Margaga Margaga Panthavat Sarvavyapi Mahavishnu Reva. Who is this Margagami? He is Vishnu Avatara Vyasa. Manohari Kamalavat Shuddhanta Karanaha Ete Purushaha Na Sakantakastana Arhaha. So these Shishyas should not be hurt by the thorns. Kintu Matsvarupa Prapti Yogya Eveti Iti Nichitya Sri Veda Vyasa Rupena Avatirya Tan Shishyan Atma Tattvopadesha Rupe Sotsange Stapayamasa. So Mahavishnu himself took avatara as Sri Veda Vyasa to let all the Shishyas who should not be hurt by the thorns as thrown by the Dvaitins, thorns being all the kama karma rupa. So the shishyas should become swarupa prapti yogya, mat swarupa, atma swarupa, ishvara swarupa, paramatma swarupa. That kind of prapti yogyatvam should be attained by them. Therefore, they should be led away from kama karma rupa thorns and should be placed in such a place where they can get chitta shuddhi ityadi, and then they should be protected. Just like the mother puts the child on her lap and protects. Similarly, Veda Vyasa puts all the shishyas on his lap and protects them from these dvaitavadis. Yatha prachandopi vayuhu kasyachit utsangasthani pushpani uddhartum na prabhavati. When it is windy, whatever you value, you will hold closely in your lap. You will not let it go. And then, however strong the wind is, it is not going to blow these things away. So you are holding on to those flowers in your lap. Similarly, tatha brahmanishtacharya upadeshadhinam purusham bhedavadi sunipuna tarkairapi bhamayitum na shaknoti. So these dvaitis are hidden tarkikas. They'll not use Shruti as Pramana really. Thereby, what will happen? They confuse the Shishyas. Whereas, when Brahmanishta Acharya Upadesha, Adhina one becomes Adhina, commits to that, then that Purusha cannot be confused by even Bhedavadi who is Nipunain, Sunipunain Tarka. नैषा तर्केण मतिरापनेया इत्यादि श्रुतेः. So Shruti says that even Tarka cannot make you reach there. Anyway, we'll stop here. It's quite a long section, so I don't want to complete this. We already gone beyond time. We'll continue from here in the next part. Sukanityam Saprakasham Vyapakam Namarupa Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhya.